Hello friends, and welcome to this video in which I would like to tell you about a very beneficial and time-saving feature of Marg Software, that is Supplier to Retailer Transaction Sync. This feature is a two-way communication between supplier and retailer through which they can carry out transactions through computer talk. This feature receives purchase order from retailer's Marg Software through cloud and automatically converts them to sale order in the supplier's Marg Software. So let's see how this works. Suppose both the retailer and the supplier are Marg users. The retailer places his order to the supplier through Marg Software. Then the supplier receives that order in his software and generates that order's sale bill. Now that bill will be sent to the retailer's software as purchase bill. This will automate the order to dispatch process from retailer to supplier. This will also save time. This will reduce 50% of manual work, as there will be no need to do manual entry of sale and purchase. And there will be no chances of mistake in generating orders, which will increase work efficiency. So let's see how to implement this feature in Marg Software. So these are the implementation steps for the supplier and the retailer. So firstly, both the supplier and the retailer have to register themselves in e-business setup. After you register in e-business setup, a unique code will be generated for you. If you have not registered yourself in eBusiness Setup, then you will go on Masters and enter on eBusiness Setup. Click on Register Company and fill your company details, then click on Submit. Then once you restart your eBusiness Setup, so here you will see a unique eBusiness code has been generated for you. Then both the retailer and the supplier will create each other's ledger and define their eBusiness code in it. To define eBusiness code in ledger, we'll go on Masters, Ledger Master and enter on Modify Ledger. Select the ledger of the customer, enter on ledger detail, and define the e-business code here. As soon as you define the e-business code of the ledger, then you will see that in e-business setup, in other mapped customers tab, that customer or supplier will get mapped. Then both the retailer and the supplier have to run server.exe. Through server.exe, your software data synchronization will be on. Means whatever sale and purchase you'll make will be sent to one another's software through server.exe. To run server.exe, you'll go on your Marg folder and enter on server.exe. Then enter. Then set yes on eBusiness data synchronize and set the time according to your requirement. Then enter. So in this way, your server application is running and your data synchronization is on. After running server.exe, the order process can begin. So when the retailer will send purchase order to supplier, that purchase order will be reflected as sale order in supplier software. Then when the supplier will convert that sale order into sale bill, that sale bill will be reflected as purchase bill in retailer software. If the retailer returns that order to the supplier, then that purchase return will be reflected as sale return in supplier software. So let's implement this process in Marg Software. Firstly, let's generate a purchase order from retailer software. So this is the retailer software and the server.exe of the retailer is also on. So let's generate purchase order. Enter. Here select the ledger of the supplier whom we registered in eBusiness setup. Suppose Seagull Suppliers. Then load the items on the bill which we want to order. So we have loaded 3 items in this bill: Amifru, Crocine and Vix. Now let's save this bill. Now this bill will be reflected in supplier software in sale order window and sale bill window. The supplier can either do entry of this purchase order in sale order first or directly in the sale bill. So let's see how. So this is the supplier software. Let's go on sale order window. So here you see that purchase order which the retailer made is reflected here. We'll click on it. Enter. Click on unmatched to map the items. Enter. So these are the items which are added in the bill. Now we have to match these items with the items in our software. Like we'll match Amifru with Amifru 25 mg. Crocine with Crocine Pain Relief and Vix with Wix VaporUp. Then press Escape and enter on Yes to save changes. Then enter on Accept. So all these items have been loaded in the bill. Now we can save this bill. Now the supplier will convert the sale order to sale bill. So let's convert the sale order to sale bill. So the bill has been made. Now this sale bill will be reflected in the purchase window of the retailer. So this is the retailer software. Let's go on purchase window. So this is the purchase bill. We'll simply click on it. Enter. Enter on select. Enter. To map the items, we'll enter on unmatched. Then enter on accept. So the items have been loaded. And now you can save this bill. Further on, if the retailer purchase returns this bill, then that will be reflected in the supplier software for sale return. So whatever transaction takes place between the retailer and the supplier will be reflected in each other's software. So friends, in this way we learned about supplier to retailer transaction sync option in Marg Software. Thanks for watching.
Press the bell icon and never miss any of our videos. Hit the like button if you found this video useful. Comment to share your views. And finally, subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.